Cool. I think I'll move on to the rapid fire questions. Nilankar, I'll start with you. When do we go back to the pre-COVID level of growth in India? This is like an overall assessment.
At least 18 months from now.
Okay. Would there be less jobs in the next 12 months?
No, there'll be more jobs.
Excellent. Would average wages be going down?
No, because of a lot of transition of workers, rather in certain sectors, it will be inflation, like Karthik pointed out. And for others, definitely people will remain more of a status quo.
Right. So, also, do you think there would be an antibiotic reactions from organizations, a much bigger antibiotic reactions from organization to anything permanent, whether it is real estate, whether it's wage structures or employees?
There'll be some knee-jerk reaction for a very temporary phase, but the larger enterprise or organizations with a long vision, definitely in 18 months, no reactions would take place. Everyone would like to wait and watch.
Okay. So how many of your guest workers or migrant workers have left?
We per se don't have that in our projects. Most of so we have a few a large amount of contractors. As per my understanding, we have not yet faced that crisis because these are mostly skilled workers or highly skilled workers because the nature of business we are.
Sure. So with this whole new phenomena that have hit us, how much percentage of your workforce is likely to permanently move to work from home?
As of now, we are going in phases. We are taking a term for around the next 12 months. We might get back entire 100% back to work, or we may just ensure that 30 to 35%, I'm talking about a final outcome, may remain working, 30 to 35% remain working from home. And then there are a set of field staff. So we would still have around 40 to 50 odd percent of people who are required to work from office because of the nature of the job.
Interesting. So thanks so much. That brings us to an end to your rapid fire questions. Now, Karthik, same questions for you.
Yeah.
When do we go back to the pre-COVID level of growth?
I wish I had a crystal ball in front of me. But I think, as I said, I think by the time things settle down, I think it'll be somewhere in mid 2022.
Okay. Would there be less jobs in the next 12 months?
I'm not sure there'll be less jobs, but I think it'll be a status quo.
Okay. And would there be a dip in way average wages in the next 12 months?
With reference to I think with reference to the migrant workers and unskilled workers and semi-skilled workers, definitely there'll be hike in the wages because of the shortage of laborers in the market. With reference to I think the white collar jobs, it's going to be I think it's going to be constant, or it could be or there could be a possible dip depending on the industry and depending on how the companies are performing. And definitely, I think the kind of bonuses, kind of increments which we have seen in the last few months will have take a definite hit.
Would there be a much greater antibiotic reaction from organization towards permanent real estate, wages, employees now after COVID?
Could you rephrase your question?
So essentially, would there be an antibiotic reactions from corporates, organizations towards anything permanent in nature, whether it's permanent real estate, permanent wage structures, permanent employees?
Actually, no, because people don't know how things are, how the market is going to react. To be really honest, the big countries like India, US, and Brazil have still not hit the peak yet. So we still don't know, I mean, how long this entire situation is going to continue. So unless and until there's clarity with reference to either vaccines or with reference to when the COVID situation is going to stabilize, I don't think people are going to take any specific permanent decisions on this. People will wait and watch. I think but it should be towards somewhere in Q1, where people will start reviewing the situation.
Thanks. So how many of your guest workers or migrant workers have left work? I mean, have gone back home?
I wish not to answer that question.
Okay. And how much percentage of your workforce would be permanently working now from home?
I don't think I'm the right person to answer that question. I'm sorry.
So I think that brings us to an end to today's session.